this video, I'll show you how to change the video container inside Handbrake from M4V to MP4 so that if you're working with videos in MP4 format, you don't keep changing it when you're saving. It's not once or twice that I've forgotten to change that particular container and it results in an M4V video. The M4V container is similar to the MP4 container, but the M4V container has been developed by Apple. So let's say you're working with MP4 files and you want them to be rendered or encoded from Handbrake in the MP4 container. You need to change this so that you can always keep your videos in sync with what you're working on. So let's begin off by opening up Handbrake. So if you don't have it and you want to use it to transcode or permanently burn in subtitles to your video, then you may need to download it. The link is in the description below. So here we have it, and we can go to the preferences without even adding any file. But let's say we add a file. Let's say we open a single file. Let's say we open this particular video. This video is an MP4 video file. Just click on open. And once we click on open, you'll notice that when you watch the save as option here, it indicates M4V. So this is what we need to change so that each time we open or want to transcode a video, we don't have to change this. Now let's come up to tools, preferences, and then we'll go to the output files. Now from the output files, we'll go to the MP4 extension, which has been set to automatic. Let's just click on this and say always use MP4. Just click on that. Once you do that, just go back. And then let's say we just close this out and then open up Handbrake again. This Handbrake, let's open up our video file again. Here we go, open. And now the video container has changed to MP4. So anytime you're working with MP4 files, you don't need to keep changing this particular extension, which is quite tiresome, especially if you're a freelancer and you work for clients. Sometimes you tend to forget and compress or encode the video and the extension is for M4V. And the client keeps asking themselves what is going on. So basically, that is how you change the M4V container in Handbrake to the MP4 container. It's pretty simple, and I hope that this video is going to be of value to someone that has been having a hard time changing the container all the time. I hope that this is going to be of value. Thank you for watching, and until next time, stay safe and never stop learning. Thank you for watching.